Welcome back to my channel. So today's video I'm hoping is going to be helpful to some of you guys, and it's all about organization. I get tons of questions every single day across all my social media from people who want to know the best way to stay organized and stay on top of things, and they always complimented me saying that, "Shirley, you seem so organized and I like the way that you do this." But don't get me wrong, I am not the most organized person out there. I do like to be organized, but geez, there's sometimes where it's just so hard just to, you know, get everything in place and stick to routine, stick to plans and things like that. But these tips I always come back to whenever I need to sort of like refresh myself, and I thought I'd share them with you guys in the hopes they would help some of you. Number one, organize your space. This helps you know what you have. I say to get rid of things that you don't use and make space for things that you do use. It helps to keep your space clear. I don't know about you guys, but when my space is clear and everything is in place, I feel like I can think better. And it's really strange because I find that reducing visual clutter around the place helps to reduce mental clutter. You might not think it, but if you go around, if you're in an environment where everything is literally cluttered and things are just all over the place, disorganized, it's very hard for you to be able to think properly. I don't know, maybe I'm just talking about myself here, but I find that if you do get rid of the clutter and, you know, find a place for everything, you can breathe. Number two is very short and sweet points, but it's to make a habit of putting things back in their place after using them. So if you use a brush for your hair, a brush for your eyeshadow, just use it and then just put it back where it belongs. If you're gonna, you know, use a plate in the kitchen, or, you know, use a couple of dishes, wash them straight after you've use them. Don't leave them there for it to pile up into, like, you know, all the way up to Mount Kilimanjaro. You know, wash it after it's been used and then put it back in its place. Number three, use a calendar. Now, you can make your own like I did. I made my own on a piece of A3 paper, or you can actually buy calendars from any like stationery store. WH Smith, Foils, Tiger, you can literally get calendars anywhere. I find that having calendars is a very good way to, you know exactly what it is you're going to be doing. So jotting down all of your important appointments and events and things, and keeping it in a place that you can see so that you can refer to every single day. It's very, very good. So you know, and you don't forget appointments and things like that. So yeah, definitely get a calendar. And I like to make my own because it just has this kind of like personal element, but you can buy them from the store if you want. Oh, this is October. I haven't filled it out yet, but I'm going to do that later on today. Number four, use a planner or a diary. Just as useful as using a calendar, but I find that this one's a bit more specific, especially if you have specific appointments or specific things that you have to do on a daily basis. It does help just jotting them down in your diary as well as your calendar. And then you can refer to it when you're on the go as well, not just in a place in your house, but you can actually look at it when you're on your way to work, when you're at school, or just before a meeting, or maybe you just want to refer to it just anytime during the day. So it is worth having a planner or a diary. Number five, make lists. I'm constantly making lists, from shopping lists to to-do lists to lists about things I want to get, so what I want to do. It just helps, you know, get everything out of my head and onto paper. And I've said this before on an Instagram post, but my dad once told me that the shortest pencil is much better than the longest memory, because everything can get jumbled up in there, but then once you jot it down, it's out of your mind, it's on a piece of paper, and you can refer back to it, and that way you're not going to forget. So I make lists on everything. I tend to make them on post-it notes, but you can have like a separate notebook from your planner, or you can use your planner to make a list of things that you need to do, and then you just tick them off as you go. I really like doing that. Number six, utilize the notepad apps on your phone. They are so useful. I find that ideas or things I have to do, or, you know, random thoughts just pop up at the randomest times, and sometimes I'm like, oh, I need to write it down and I can't find my pencil or I can't find my diary. I find that the notepad apps on here are so useful. I have tons and tons of notes where I literally just get an idea for anything and I just write it down, and then I can go back and I can look at it. And one thing I like about smartphones is that they have so many different types of notepads that you can actually customize to your liking. I just use the normal one that comes with the phone, but yeah, I just literally jot down every single thing that comes to my mind at the oddest times, just so that I don't forget them. Because, like, usually the best ideas come when you're not really thinking about them, or when you least expect it. So using your phone to jot down important things. Number seven, beat procrastination. I find that it is the enemy of progress. And when you want to get something done, procrastination just comes in and it's like, You can chill. You could just look at that wall over there. That white wall is so much more interesting than doing your homework. And it comes in so many different forms. One of the forms it comes in, and I do this a lot, I'm so guilty of this, it's social media. I have a love-hate relationship with social media because I absolutely love going on there just so I can see what everyone is getting up to. I get inspiration from there as well. But one of the things that it does to me is it makes me stay on it for a really long time. I'll be on Facebook and then I've seen someone has posted a video of Vine and I would laugh for ages because it's a funny video. Vine is usually very funny. And then before I know it, I'm clicking through the next Vine over and over again. Oh, I check out what that person's doing over there, what that person's doing over there. And before I know it, I spent hours on the social media site. So what am I trying to say? Social media sometimes is very good to get inspiration and to keep up with your friends and family and stuff, but it shouldn't really be a distraction. You shouldn't allow it to be a distraction. So make a conscious effort to say that I'm going to go on just for a couple of minutes or for an hour, however long you want to go on, and then come off, because it's actually a very big thing when it comes to procrastination. It literally goes hand in hand with procrastination. Which leads me on to the next thing about setting time frames. You don't have to set time frames for just social media. You can set time frames for anything. So like a task that you want to do, you know, an errand that you want to run, you can make a mental note or you can make a written note of how long you want to spend on it. That way you don't go over time, and sometimes you might not be able to do it in the time that you set for yourself. Just move on to another task and then come back to it, so rather than spending all of your time, because that's another way you can waste time if you spend too much time on one particular task. Also, do the task that you are dreading the most. So if you have to do the washing up or the dry cleaning, or you have to go down to the post office and that's the thing that you're dreading the most when you wake up in the morning, do it first. That way you get it out and it's not hanging over your head while you're doing other fun tasks. The last one is to ask for help. Sometimes there are tasks that can't be done efficiently by yourself, which is why you have to enlist help. And don't be afraid to ask for help. Ask your family, ask your friend. And you know, most times you're able to get the task done and done properly. So don't be afraid to ask for help if you need help. So those are my tips on how to stay organized. Some of them are very, very easy, and I know some of them you guys already know, but I thought I'd just, you know, compile all of them in one video, just so that if anyone needs some kind of a refresh when it comes to organizing themselves, or maybe need a few tips on how to stay organized, they can come back and watch this video. There will be times where you can't be as organized as you want to be, and in some cases it might not even be your fault. It might be another person's fault that's a bit disorganized. I know a thing or two about having other people in my life that are a bit disorganized. Some of my family members are a bit disorganized and they really drive me nuts. But you have to, you know, make room for that, and you know, be gentle. You know, say to yourself that you can't do it at this point in time, but you do it another time where you can. Also try to be flexible, because circumstances can change. You might be really used to a particular routine, or used to doing things in a certain way or at a certain time. But things can change, and you have to open up your mind to allow those things to change, and then you just go back to routine or go back to whatever it is you're doing when you can do it. Don't get stressed. I know that sometimes when you want to stay on top of things and you want to stay organized and you want to get tasks done and you want to, you know, lead an easy, simple life, if things are put in place, you can get stressed doing that. But just always bear in mind that no situation is perfect. I really hope you guys enjoyed the video. Make sure you thumbs up if you did. And please leave comments down below with your tips on how to stay organized. And get the conversation flowing in the comment section. And I'll see you guys soon. Thank you so much for watching. Bye. Very sweet and very sure. Look at my calendars. I actually drew them myself. I'm so extra. I'm so extra, but I like being extra. You know what? My friends and family call me Shirley Bassey Extra. But hey, I like being extra. It's just me, meh. But yeah, this is my calendar that I did myself. And this November, I do actually have some notes of videos I'm going to be making in November, and I did the same thing for December as well. Ooh. Ruin my lipstick with this stupid calendar. You're meant to be starring in the video with me. You're not meant to be ruining my makeup. I'm going to do still now. Okay. Should I do? No, I shouldn't do still. Good, forget him. Yay. treat me so much better than him. And if I was sane, there'll be no competition. But I'm in love with someone else. Yeah, breathe.